Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to do a code reviews which we just talked about, and we will try to use all the principles and fundamentals which we have learned throughout the video series. So I mean, this is just a GitHub PR and we are just trying to have a look onto this function, and we can see that it's using async await and it is making two different calls. From first await we are getting data and that is being passed. So these are actually two dependent calls, right? And I think these are already structured in the proper way. We are using async await, so we should be good here. Coming down to this example, here you can say we are writing async functions and there are a lot of, you can say, promises are written. Like there are three promises. One is for apple, grapes and fruits. There are many ways to optimize it. Like if there are like number of apples are there is in an array, then you can iterate on an array and write a for loop. I will just try to put that in the code, how we can see this, how we can optimize it. So you can just simply write a for loop, let a k of apples, k of fruits. Okay, by doing this, what you can do is now you are getting each and every fruit. You can simply do await get number of fruit and you can just pass the fruit name here. So it will act in the same way. You don't need to repeat it three times doing the same thing. Right here you can get the, you can, whatever the data you are getting, you can actually put that data into another array. I mean, for of loop would be enough to fix this thing. Instead of doing a three iteration, we can get everything inside a simple for of loop. Now, example three. So in this example, you can see we are doing get JSON, we are getting promise, then from promise response, we are checking something, and then we are again calling another method, which is returning a promise. I will try to make it more simpler. I think now it is more clear from the nesting. This is what we are doing, right? So now what we can do, I mean, there is a necessary check and we should be able to optimize it. How we can do it, we can actually convert this into async await. This is our function. We can actually put this whole block. We should be able to expand it. Yeah, so this is my new suggestion. What we can do is, okay, let me get the whole block. So instead of doing this, what we can do is we can actually await a promise. Await get JSON. It will actually give me the data. Now here I can just check if data dot need to make another request, then I can actually convert this into another response. This is another response we are getting, so we can move it to await. We can just remove this thing. Okay, and we can actually, if you want to return, this is what we can do, another. Otherwise, if this condition is false, then we will return whatever the response we got from here. So this first thing was a response.needReview. So this code looks cleaner than whatever we have written. A lot of conditions and promises, we can clean that using async await. And obviously this function need to be async in that case. And you can raise a commit also for this. Okay, now coming to this. Here we have written like load data and we are writing a lot of promises inside it. Let me just zoom it a little bit. Here we are doing one promise dot then. It's like a promise chain. And if these promises are independent, then obviously you have a good opportunity to split them into individual promises. That's what we are doing. In load data, we are actually splitting these promises individually. Await promise 1, P1, P2, P3. And if you are comfortable, you can do it the promise dot all and just put all these promises in an array. Okay, coming to another example, here you can see I'm talking about this example. What we are doing here is we are get data is a callback. It is resolving a promise and returning a callback. So I mean, here we are mixing promises and callback, which is not an idle way. I mean, it can generate some errors. Although promises and callbacks can work together, but we should adopt a common strategy. We can just write, end up writing just only promises. So this get data also can return a simple promise, like get employees is returning a promise, right? So get data can simply return a promise, and here we have written that. So if you see this block, we are calling get data, and from the callback we are returning the response, right? Instead of doing this, we simply can do is we can actually convert this get employee method into a promise. This is most of the time we do is return new promise, resolve and reject. We can use these callbacks, and here based on whatever we are getting, we can just put it inside this. Now if we got the response, we will just resolve this with the response. Or if we got error in the, and it's going inside a catch, then we can actually reject this. So here we don't need to actually read it like a callback. Get data, don't need to use the callback here. Get data dot then, if we got data, we will get it. A simple simplified way of doing it, right? So there are many examples. Now another example is just about array. So you should always remember that whenever you are writing a simple for loop, you can use a break, continue, that is fine, and you can return, right? But when you are writing a callback way of doing these things, like simply you are writing a for each loop, a map or filter, and you are trying to return from that loop, it will not happen. I mean, it will not break the sequence, it will execute all. So if you are writing it simply using for loop, that is fine. And if you try to optimize it, okay, let's use a for each loop or map or filter here, something like this, which I'm going to talk about is, I mean, it's just a downside of it. If you try to optimize it in just another way of writing a for each loop, considering, okay, let's do it in the for each. I mean, this is not a code refactoring. I'm just saying avoid doing this. So here, if you think you can do and you can break the sequence, this is not possible while doing it in the for each loop, map or any kind of, these are callbacks, right? You can't return from these callbacks. Even if you are returning, the sequence will still go. Even if you do a break, continue, that is not going to affect these for each loops and all. Okay, other small examples are like this. Here we have a is number, is boolean function. We are doing a lot of checks, returning too many values. This can be simply written is number, and we can just return because type of this comparison itself is returning true or false, right? So we can just say return type of this is number. Similarly, type of test is boolean, then return false, otherwise true. Simply we can just do the negation of this condition. If test not equal to boolean, it will return true or false, right? Parse int, here also we are doing a lot of return statements. I mean, this is a real example of code smell which people end up writing. Here we are checking value if it is not a number or not. Instead of this, we can say whatever we are getting from this, otherwise return 0. This is what we are doing. If it is not a number, return 0, otherwise return value. After doing parse int, the same thing we can do here, right? Sometimes we currently we are not doing this mistake because now we have arrow functions. Earlier we used to do alias for this into another variable and used to access that this inside a nested callback function. Now that is not a problem. You can actually use arrow function, you can do a dot bind this, All these things will help you to fix this problem. So this is the fix for the above code. Okay, so I mean, doing or writing code makes you smart, and this will keep help you to review your code by yourself. So it's a like a long process. When you keep doing it, you will become expertise in this, and you always think, can I optimize this? Can I use? So these are some of the principles which you should follow, like remove the unused code, use switch statement, avoid nested callbacks, use async await or promises, don't create a large classes, don't create a large objects, don't create a functions in the global scope, don't create a variables in the global scope, don't pollute the global scope, don't put empty catch blocks. If you are thinking, okay, you want to throw an error, then throw new error or create your own custom exceptions and throw that in your application. You can think about running API calls either parallelly or sequentially. If those are independent, then you can also run those calls parallelly using promise.all. You can use all these utilities. Don't mix promises with a callback, either go with the promise or just clean this up using async await. Okay, these all are actually best practices to write a clean code. I hope this playlist will help you to write more clean code in your projects. Thanks everyone.